Hey guys, Paul here with Diode Dynamics, introducing the newest member of the Stage Series LED lineup. Now, you've probably heard of the SS3 3-inch LED Pod, as well as its little brother, the SSC2 LED. This one's really compact, but we wanted to take it a step further, and that brings us to the SSC1 LED. Now, as you can tell, this is only using a single emitter, but it still packs a huge punch because it uses a 10-watt LED for the Sport or a 20-watt LED for the Pro. Just a huge amount of light output, especially for how compact this thing is. It's really pretty amazing. This can be used to add accessory light or just a little bit of extra visibility anywhere you want. In fact, some of our guys here have installed these on the side of SS3 brackets, just bolting right up to angle a little bit of light off to the side, for example. You can really build these and put them together any way you want to get the exact output you're looking for. And they're available in three different beam patterns. We've got the flood, which is gonna spread light everywhere. The spot, which of course is just gonna focus all that light with those TIR optics and direct it way down the road. Or the new wide optic, which is kind of like a combo. It's gonna be somewhere in between, just providing a nice amount of fill light. Whatever you pick, these are easy to change out because you can purchase the lenses separately. If you're familiar with the Stage Series, these work the same way. Just remove the four Torx screws on the back, pop it out, and you'll be back on the road in just a couple of minutes. You can also change out the color, although the LEDs inside do have slight difference between the white and yellow from the factory. But as you can see, they are available in that white and yellow output color, either a 6000K white, which is really nice, matching the rest of the LEDs on your vehicle, as well as the whole Stage Series lineup, or that selective yellow color. Really great to give it a distinct look and to cut through dusty or inclement weather conditions. Now, these are available in two different frame options as well, meaning this front faceplate. First, we've got the standard faceplate. As you can see, it's got the trademark ICO bezel design, or we've got the flush mount option as well. Really compact flush mount light, great to provide a little bit of extra light on a bumper, side of a trailer, anything like that where you want it to mount flush. Finally, the last big feature of these lights is they all come standard with a backlight option. The way it works is we can flip on a backlight. Here we have the amber, and then when you flip on the main beam, it'll automatically turn off and that main beam will illuminate. As you can see, it's a lot brighter. Then you turn off your main beam, the backlight will come back on. This is a great way to add a little extra running light or accent anywhere, or just give it some style anywhere you want these mounted. Now, these are available in four different colors: white, amber, blue, and red. The red is a perfect match with that flush mount, especially if you're using that on the rear of a vehicle. You can have that running at all times and then flip on an extra white light to, say, be an extra reverse light anytime you'd like. Now, the SSC1 is already really versatile, can mount just about anywhere, but we've taken that a step further with a new series of brackets as well. They all ship standard with the stainless steel bracket, which is really compact, totally adjustable. You can mount this just about anywhere. But say you have a GoPro setup with GoPro adapters. They're really convenient, and we have a GoPro mounting kit now as well. These come with a 90 degree as well as a straight standard mount, along with a quick disconnect, a snap fit mount as well. These might be really handy if you've already got mounting setups or you just want to be able to change that light out really quick. They're available for a really low cost with your order, and they're available for the SSC2 as well. It's the same fitment. So that might be another great option for a way to add some light where you need it. Finally, we do have lens covers available. Whether you're looking to change the output color with a set of our amber covers or add some protection and style, as you can see, they just come right on and off, snapping on securely to the light whenever you need to. These are also available online, nominal cost, really to get you the full setup that you might need. The last thing we want to show you is the output patterns. If you want to see how the Sport and Pro stack up in white and yellow with all those different beam patterns, go ahead and skip to the end of the video. But there's one thing to cover first, and that's how these stack up against other lights in their class. Now, when it comes to that single LED pod layout, there's only other two major players in the space. That's Baja Designs with the S1 LED and Rigid Industries with the Ignite. Now, all three of these are really well-built lights, good quality, you shouldn't have any problems there. But just taking a look, there's a couple differences in the features we want to note. First, the size. As you can see, the SSC1 is almost the same in size as the S1 LED. The faceplates are very similar and the depth is almost the same as well. Just something to keep in mind if you're looking to swap them out or mount that up. And then you have the Rigid Ignite, much smaller. While these are 2 inches, this is about 1.4, really, really compact. I think this is the smallest light out on the market for automotive pods. But there is a difference in the overall power as well. And let's take a look at just the spot patterns to show you a quick comparison. The Rigid Ignite is only available with a 10 watt emitter inside. So as you can see, even though it's way more compact, it is lower power than the other options. The Diode Dynamics SSC1 Sport also has a 10 watt emitter, but does use a more focused optic. Then we move up to the Diode Dynamics SSC1 Pro, which uses a 20 watt emitter. This is a huge amount of light coming out of the form factor. Finally, the Baja Designs S1 is very similar to the C1 Pro because it also uses a 20 watt emitter, also a pretty high power light. So as you can see, there's basically 4 different power levels to choose from between Rigid, Diode, and Baja Designs in this form factor. Couple more comparison features to mention is the connector coming out the back. As you can see, Baja and Rigid use the wiring. Rigid doesn't include a connector, although Baja does. Of course, Diode Dynamics have the built-in connector that your harness will plug into. But finally, maybe the biggest difference between all of these lights is the backlight. Diode Dynamics is the only one to offer a backlight in this form factor. Again, available in white, red, amber, and blue. Baja and Rigid don't have a backlight for now on this size of light. So that's something to keep in mind, especially if you're looking to use these as accent lights somewhere on your vehicle. I hope this video has been helpful in learning a little bit about the new SSC1 LED and how it stacks up against the competition. If you have any questions, please feel free to give us a call or shoot us an email. We'll be happy to help you determine what you need for your application. Diode Dynamics lights are available online at diodynamics.com or all major lighting retailers. Thanks for watching.